Hey everyone, this is Mohan here from SAKTHI Tech, and today we'll be answering the age-old question of, is an iPad useful for an engineering student? Let's find out! So this video will be obviously divided into the pros and cons of owning an iPad. So we'll move on to the first pro of today. The first pro is that having an iPad acts as a digital library of sorts. And the thing is, you're only limited by the storage size of this iPad. You can store anything documentation related into this iPad. If you have journal articles, if you have your presentation slides from your lecture, problem sheets, your solutions and workings of your problem sheets, and even your sketches and mind maps related to your programming work and so on. And you have the power of the Apple Pencil, which is a huge game changer. You can annotate to all your heart's content and do all of your mathematic problem sheets without a single piece of paper. And it makes things so much more easier to organize with applications such as GoodNotes, Notability, which is my personal favorite, and also OneNote. You can use these applications, put them into separate folders and tabs, and some of the applications such as Notability even enables you to do object character recognition based search. So what does that mean? It can basically search through your own handwriting, which is a huge game changer, because 1 week before your exams, during study week, when you need to find a particular solution to a problem sheet, you'll be thanking the iPad gods for letting you do this. You can search through your problem sheet super easily and you can find what you need right away. Now, moving on to the second pro of having an iPad, this is more of a personal anecdote in my opinion, but I've had some friends share similar sentiments as well. When it comes to classes, sometimes it can get really draggy, complicated, and you might lose interest in them. And for me personally, I find that happening quite often, especially in my first years of study. So I've always looked to different solutions that I can take on to help improve this. One of those purported solutions was having an iPad. And to my amazement, it actually did help so much. This was like my favorite friend. It's the first thing that I take out during class. And it helped me keep my brain engaged with all my doodling and sketches on top of the presentation slides. Let's say the topic is about electrical motors. Sometimes I'll draw out the stator, the armature of the motor, and I'll then try to understand how it works visually, as it works best for me. With this, my attention span increased quite a bit, and I really found myself enjoying classes a bit more. And even that tiny bit of extra enjoyment really made a huge difference, I think. Now, let's move on to the cons of having an iPad as an engineering student. Now, a lot of people like to talk about the iPad as that be-all, end-all computer. Well, sadly, I don't think it can ever be the be-all, end-all computer for an engineering student, at least. Now, what do I mean by that? A lot of software such as MATLAB, SolidWorks, KiCad for PCB design, all of these things, they don't have a good Apple iPad-based version on them at the moment. Most of the ones that are on iPad are like severely cut down versions, web-based versions, and they don't get the job done. You eventually still need your laptop at one point. And that's one thing you'll have to accept. You'll need an iPad and a conventional laptop like I have here, or a desktop PC. The iPad will not be your one and only computer, not anytime soon at least. So one of my main recommendations for engineering students out there who are interested in getting an iPad, please don't get the iPad Pro, because it's not going to be your only computer, right? So even the iPad base model would serve you way more than enough functions. I would recommend the iPad Air as well. It's pretty great value if you prefer the newer Apple Pencil, which I do and I recommend. In conclusion, the iPad might not make a huge sense to an engineering student. It's not a need, it's more of a want. Having it improves different aspects of your engineering life in ways that you might find surprising, and you'll find yourself integrating it into your workload more than you think. It's not an absolute necessary thing, but if you can spare the funds, I'm sure it'll make a great tool in your arsenal. With that, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you guys watching these videos. Do subscribe, like, comment, share, the usual jazz. And do leave a comment down below. Do you guys use an iPad during your studies? Are you an engineering student as well? How has that been like? Get a cool discussion running in the comment section below. I'll make sure to join in. All right, thank you. See you guys then. Bye-bye.